Hello.
Hi.
We're playing for honor today.
No, the beta only came out yesterday or the day before. Either one.
Day before. So I've played a little bit now, and I've got a basic understanding of the combat. I am no professional by any means, any stretch of the imagination. We're playing against bots, so I think it's a team of human characters versus the bots. This guy is heavy.
Is.
He's getting revengey as well. Oh, not the revenge.
So I picked it up. I picked up the For Honor beta on PS4, but I only really went for the tutorial because I don't like fighting against people.
I did some of the player versus player, so I've actually had a match against other people. This is the first time I'm playing against AI. Whoop.
Oh, cool.
Saying that heavy was quite difficult to take down. I'm playing quite a light character for the samurai. So I've got a Naginata, I think it's called. Basically, a spear. fancy Japanese spear.
I
The.
went out with a girl once. She was a Naginata.
It's. So basically, it's capture the flag. You can play like a dueling mode as well, so you can actually do sort of one versus one dueling and that kind of thing.
All right.
We've got our army of these kind of regular dudes. They're just kind of cannon fodder more than anything else. And then you have your
Nice.
kind of heroes. So we've got four hero characters floating around the place. The only other thing that's really weird is the friendly fire. You can actually hurt your teammates by swinging around a bit too much.
Dear.
So now we're kind of in a dueling section. I'm stuck on a stairway. Woo! Oh, he's fallen down. Okay.
He did.
That's
A small
yeah.
fall has killed him.
Small stairs, the true enemy.
The true enemy of the Knights of the Old.
Where are we going? Okay, so it's point A over here.
So, oh, there's only one of the bots left.
In the ooh, what's this over here?
B, do you open up a.
No.
You damn kids!
Denied.
Oh,
I
one
can't
of them's
jump
been
down there.
revived.
Yeah, so I think that when your hero's full, you can when you're actually killing them, you can do a special attack which actually like chops the head off or something, and that
Oh,
stops them
nice.
from being revived.
Yeah.
But if they're just sitting around on the floor, they can actually be revived by the teammates.
Oh, cool.
So it's kind of you do get a second chance, but it just depends on how you've been killed. If they've done a really good job of it, then you're pretty screwed.
If you've been, I mean, there's a difference between dead and really dead.
Exactly, yeah. Just on the floor, bleeding profusely.
Help me. Pass me my head.
So I'm trying to kind of show off the dueling combat a bit, because there's basically three positions, and you have to kind of match up the position they're trying to attack you with the way that you're defending. So as you hold, I'm using a controller here. So if I hold L2, I'm now in like the dueling kind of stance, and I've got bottom left, bottom right, and then upwards.
Yeah.
And if you attack and they're not defending in the same stance that you are, then you hit them, and
Nice.
vice versa. So if they attack you in a stance that you're not defending in, then they can hit you. So the idea is that you're just trying to kind of match up each other's stances, but also switch up when you're trying to go on the offensive. And these
Sort of like
cannon
a
fodder
rock.
guys get in the way. Yeah, rock, paper, scissors kind of style, yeah.
Yeah. Rock,
It's
paper, scissors difference.
quite intense though, because you're trying to kind of focus on one guy, but you've also got lots of other people around in the same area. So it's not quite the same as the dueling. I'd imagine the dueling you can focus a bit more on picking the right positions and things like that. Another mechanic that you can just see this person doing is revenge. So I
Yeah.
think if you're being attacked by more than one person, you get this kind of revenge opportunity, and you kind of go into this kind of powerful state with a bit of extra health and things like that.
Nice.
So it means that you can fight off more than one person without getting completely overwhelmed.
Yeah.
Yeah, see
That's
that
a good
person in the middle has
idea.
just gone on revenge as well. So you see like the
Yeah.
yellow glowing above his head.
All right.
I think also he's a heavy, so he's absolutely monstrous to try and take down. Ooh.
Victory!
We somehow won. That is definitely something that I've noticed when playing this, is there's so much going on the screen at once that actually you kind of don't really know what's going on entirely.
All right, fair
It
enough.
feels a bit overwhelming. There's like so much just firing off at once.
Maybe that's just a thing that you get used to the more you play.
I reckon so. You kind of learn to keep an eye on the enemy heroes rather than the kind of cannon fodder that's getting in your way and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
I'm not going to equip. We'll just wait for the next match. Ready. I'm enjoying it. It feels a tad clunky, but I think that's just the way that it's just not used to the controls and things like that yet. Mm. I think there's a lot of tactical element to it that I haven't quite learnt yet.
Yeah.
So actually trying to kind of make sure that you're blocking people and counter-attacking. So you can guard break people as well. So if people are kind of sticking to defensive, you can actually knock that defense out and you can pick them up and throw them or chuck them across a room or things like that. And there are bits of environment as well. So there's like spiked walls and things like that. So you can actually throw people onto the spiked walls.
Mm.
Not any of these things have I done yet, but
they are in the game.
It's all, yeah, they're in the game. Whether I use them or not is my choice. Don't judge me. another tactic that I found really useful is just go for the points, because points mean prizes.
Oh, nice.
So I'm going to run up here, because they're all kind of focusing on B, so I'll jump in and grab A. I'd imagine one of their heroes would be trying up and get A. Oh no, we got A. We got A with no problem. So I don't think I'm going to stick up here and wait. I think I'll jump down and try and help out with B if I can. Oh, so one of our guys is down, so let's go and try and revive him.
Could you hear, like, is there a voice chat option for the other teammates? Like, can you hear them or?
Yeah. So there's full mic support like most games online, so you can actually chat to everyone. Because we're playing with AI, I think there's only one other human player in here. Oh, we lost my name. Yeah. It's because I wasn't guarding it. You, die.
Death!
Oh, I'm not defending well.
Ooh. Same as you.
Yeah.
Shouldn't you two be friends and try and get on?
Yeah, it's for the samurai, right?
Yeah.
Come back here.
There's not many of them left now.
Yeah, short supply in 2017.
Yeah.
Oh, I am in trouble. I am in trouble. Oh, dear.
Oh, no.
Oh, help me. So, yeah, this is what I was saying earlier about the reviving, so I can hold circle and actually die automatically.
Yeah.
But that then gets rid of my body off of the map, so people can't come over and revive me. So, for example, that probably would have been better for me to actually make myself die, because then it doesn't get anybody to walk up and try and revive me when there's two heroes up there.
Okay.
So obviously it's like a trap. Whoa, oh dear, oh dear.
He's fit heavy.
I walked into pain. Oh god, up, oh dear.
That's a good effort.
Oh, that guy was on form. So that's where you can see the guy attacked on the bottom left, then top, then right. And for me to defend against that, I would have had to match him. And I was too slow in kind of responding to that.
Yeah.
Which was... I think that's the kind of intricate side to this game that I haven't picked up on yet at all. At the moment, I'm just kind of mashing and hoping for the best.
Just hope it all goes on.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm back. Kill me.
Just stay here in the back. Don't hurt
me. No one will ever notice.
We are in a bit of trouble, though. I think we're being a bit dominated in this round. So, which faction would you pick to go with? Because I'm definitely all over the samurais. That's my jam.
I reckon I'd probably go with the knights.
The knights. Yeah, see, knights is a close second.
There was a part of me that was just like, yeah, Viking all the way when this game got announced. But then the knights just looked really impressive.
I was watching a video on what's he called, Game Theorists.
Yeah.
And he did a theory on who would win if it was the actual battles. And I think they said the samurai would win outright, basically.
Well, because he's quicker.
It's to do with the weaponry at the time and that kind of thing. So plate mail wasn't a thing when all of these three guys existed in the universe.
Okay.
So at the time, no plate mail. Yeah. So it would have been like chainmail. I think it's called hauberk or something like that.
Yeah.
But because they didn't have the plate mail, the samurai were better equipped and had they're also richer, so the samurai have more money at the time, which means they could buy nicer toys.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I almost got this guy. Come back here. Not done with you.
Where's your area purple? Have you been to the doctors?
Pixies. I'm going to say pixies.
All right. I used to go to the doctors when my area gets purple.
Do you have to have the cream again?
No, it was the injection last time.
In the butt.
No.
Oh, you revived his teammate. So, right, let's try and do this properly. Come on, big boy. Come on.
Kick his guard out.
There we go. Nice. Oh, I kicked him into the fire.
Nice.
Okay. Oh, jeez. Oh, you're a big fella.
Oh, jeez.
He's quite intimidating. Oh. Okay. I think my stamina's low. That's why it's gone black and white.
Okay.
Come on, stay back.
That was a big axe.
It's really intense.
No. I hit you with a nut.
Oh, brutal. Well, I am being revived.
Why?
You do really have to concentrate. It's quite a... At least it's not second nature at the moment, but it's focusing on what way they're going to attack you, and the Vikings seem to be able to change that form really quickly.
All right.
So if you watch, like, changing between the forms for me, it does take a little bit of time to swap between the sides. But he seems to be with the axes much. Maybe that's one of the mechanics.
Maybe. Mind you, he has got a weapon in both hands as well, so he can block with both hands.
That's what I reckon is, depending on the weapon, you can move between those stances a lot quicker.
Yeah.
So I reckon that's a real advantage, because then you can defend a lot easier. But I'm guessing the people that are slower have got a bigger weapon, so they have more range and that kind of thing. I'd imagine there was a lot of balancing with this. Because it doesn't feel unfair. Like, every time I've died, it's definitely been my fault for not playing it properly, but...
Yeah.
Get out of my way, I'm trying to stab him. Whee! Did it.
Nice.
I did a thing, Dan.
His head come off.
I don't know how I did that.
I think this is out next week, isn't it? Maybe in a few days.
Very soon. I'm curious to play the single player. I think the PvP side of things not so fussed about. But I like that they've done the PvP modes with AI characters. I think that's a cool idea.
Yeah.
It isn't a game that I could see myself playing a bit like Overwatch, where you're kind of, you just jump on, play it online for a while. It's something that you'd be focused on playing.
Yeah.
So you'd learn the mechanics and you'd be playing it kind of every day and that kind of thing. But I don't see myself getting that into it to play it all the time.
All right. So or do you reckon
enough
you'll pick
to get
it
good
up,
at it? I don't know. It's if I saw it cheap somewhere, if I saw it maybe £20-25, something like that. I reckon I get it for the single player experience, but I wouldn't get it purely for the multiplayer online.
Yeah, that seems fair.
Yeah.
Fun, mate. So I'm not. Go on.
I was going to say that we're now in like the last state of a battle. So once you've grabbed all the points, like A, B, and C, you then enter this mode where you have to kill all the opponent's heroes.
Yeah.
So this is kind of like the last state of the match. Oh, I'm in trouble. I was trying to revive our teammate.
I didn't see him. Popped up from nowhere.
Just hi, stab the face. But yeah, once you've captured the points, there's then kind of a deathmatch mode, basically, where you've just got to finish everybody's main heroes off. There you go. So
your team is now breaking.
In that state because they've got all the points. So we now need to get the points back. I think someone's taking over C.
It's being disputed.
There we go. Let's jump back in. Come here, you. My doppelganger. Ooh, we've got like cinematic cam.
Oh well.
Stare
cam.
Buy
your own clothes.
Yeah, that revenge mode definitely buffed you up like crazy. Oh. Oh. I fell down.
Oh no.
Yay! Zone C's ours. Right. So now we're, yeah, now their team's breaking in, so now we've got to take out their heroes again. We need to go and grab B as well. I wonder how long this kind of goes on for, whether it's just a case of, if it's a fairly, like, balanced team, whether you spend a lot of your time just kind of going between this sort of kill the enemy hero state over and over again, or whether they kind of put some kind of limiter on it.
Well, your time keeps going up.
Oh, okay.
Your time at bar in the middle, it keeps going up to about 4 minutes. Because I looked down and it was 3:30. I looked up, it was 3:55.
Ah, so maybe when you capture the points or something, it's kind of like a countdown / kill everybody kind of mode.
Hmm. Unless it's when the opposite team break sort of thing. Yeah, it's just jumped up again. So yeah, you've just got more time.
Ah, okay. That's interesting. So let's put this down. Get my health back up. And should we pull in some arrows? We'll pull in some arrows.
That's a good feature.
Whee!
Such a small area of arrows.
Yeah, it's really... Like, I'd imagine buffs for it are probably increase the area and do more damage and that kind of thing. It'd be cool, I'm guessing, maybe fire arrows or something. That'd be kind of cool. So then you can set fire to people and hopefully try and cause a bit of chaos.
That'd be really good.
Yeah, there's a lot of mechanics in this game. It's really impressive. Like, It's clever and well done. I just don't know whether it's something for me, whether I keep playing it.
Mm. Well, I mean, that's the point of the beta.
Yeah.
Well, the point of the beta is to get people to love it. But
yeah, it's getting a lot of coverage on YouTube, which is quite interesting. The approach that they've taken to try and kind of advertise the new IP and that kind of thing.
Yeah, I think that's a half marketing scheme as well.
Yeah.
Rather than just like, look at our game that's coming out soon. It's here's some money and tell everyone how good our game is.
Love it.
Just to let anyone know that watches this that might have a games company, we are not below that. We will do that.
And on that note of selling ourselves,
yeah,
we'll catch you in the next one, guys.
Yeah, cheers, guys.
Bye.
Bye.